When the Mercedes CLK 63 AMG Black Series was launched in 2007, logic said that it would be a hardcore rival for the previously peerless BMW M3. Both had V8s, both were rear-wheel drive, and both were based on pleasant, but not especially exciting, two-door coupes. However, somewhere deep in the depths of their high-tech headquarters, AMG's engineers had other ideas. What followed was a £100,000 price tag and a claim from AMG's head of development that this was, without doubt, a rival for the Porsche 911 GT3.
For anyone that needs reminding, the 997 GT3 was one of Porsche's greatest hits. A racing car for the road, it teamed a howling flat-six engine with a chassis sent directly from motoring heaven. How then did AMG turn the soft, sensible CLK into a rival for what was one of the most exciting cars that money could buy? As transformations go, it would have to be quite something.
Aware that the standard CLK 63 wasn't going to cut the mustard, AMG gave the Black Series a thorough overhaul. As well as the forged alloy wheels, lashings of carbon and wider track front and rear, there's an entirely reworked suspension setup. Optimised for the track, it's adjustable in just about every way you can think of, from ride height to rebound and compression. What's more, the M156 V8 engine has been treated to a larger inlet manifold, reworked exhaust, and a remapped ECU, resulting in a total output of 500 brake horsepower.
Despite all of the changes though, there are still a few issues. The first of which is with the gearbox. It's a 7-speed automatic, and even by the standards of the day, it could have been a little bit better. You've obviously got the manual override paddles behind the steering wheel, and while you can get a perfectly good gear change, much of the time there's a notable delay between pulling a paddle and actually getting the gear you want, so you don't have as much control over the transmission as you'd like. Then there's the steering. The wheel itself is out of line with your driving position, so that my left nipple lines up almost exactly with the centre of the Mercedes-Benz badge. And more importantly, the shape of the wheel, it's got the flat bottom, which not everyone likes, but also where you typically hold the wheel, so around the 9 and 3 position, it's incredibly chunky, meaning that unless you've got ginormous hands, which I haven't, you might struggle to find a comfortable position or a way to hold it. And then when you do actually get comfortable, you'll find that the amount of feel you're getting through the wheel isn't all that good. It's very weighty, which is nice, but the amount of feedback that you're getting through the front wheels isn't all that much. These things aren't disastrous, it's not like you can't drive around them, but they add a layer of uncertainty that you need to get used to before you drive this car hard. However, there is one bit of this car that makes sense almost immediately. The engine. It's like they took the best bit of the regular CLK AMG and just made it even better. It doesn't actually feel that neck-snappingly quick at lower speeds, partly because of the fluffy gearbox, but mainly because even on a dry, straight road, the traction control simply can't cope with the amount of power going through the rear wheels. But put your foot down at higher speeds and this surge just builds and builds and builds until you realise that it ain't stopping for anything. You know, it's the torque that really gets you. To give you a sense of just how much it makes, the old E60 V10 M5 made 384 pound-foot of torque. This, it makes 464. And of course, the obvious byproduct of that 6.2 litre naturally aspirated V8 is the noise. Struth, it's quick.
The engine goes some way to explaining how the Black Series set an in-traffic Nürburgring time of just 7 minutes and 52 seconds. But it's only part of the story.
Once you start to trust this car, to understand how it works and how it likes to be driven, you begin to understand some very eye-opening things. The first is that there is absolutely bucket loads of grip at the front end. You can absolutely lob this 1.8 ton lump of a car into a corner at almost any speed, and it just sticks. It stays so flat and the steering is so quick that it really is remarkably keen to change direction. I honestly can't remember driving a car that feels as rear driven as this one does. There's so much going on at the back wheels, but you can feel all of it through the base of your seat. It actively encourages you to push the car through the corner, whether that be in a big drifty cloud of smoke or neat and tidy like a DTM racer. It may still be a blunderbuss at heart, but someone's gone to the very deliberate effort of lengthening the barrel and adding a scope.
There's no denying that the Black Series is a wonderful exercise in barely controlled aggression and burning rubber. A car so brimming with character, it transcends mere metal and carbon fibre. But perhaps one of the most impressive bits about the Black Series is that it hasn't forgotten how to be a CLK.
I'm now driving normally, trying to conserve what little fuel I have left, and something rather peculiar has happened. The engine has gone down to a low burble, the ride comfort is reasonable, the refinement is good, and I've got lots of nice things like dual zone climate control and cruise control. You know, if it wasn't for these seats, this steering wheel and that carbon, I'd think that I was driving around in a CLK 280. It really does feel like I've got in a different car.
And that is what makes it special. In creating a genuine 911 rival, AMG made the Black Series a Frankenstein monster that shared so little with the car on which it was based, yet somehow it's still able to revert to being that car. The big, soft, genteel cruiser hasn't been lost.
It's that split personality, that Jekyll and Hyde under one roof that is like gold dust in cars like these. So few cars get it right, yet here's one with no drive modes, no magnetic dampers, no adjustable steering weight, yet it's got the biggest mood swings of the lot. If there's one car that sums up the essence of an AMG, I think it's this one.